Michael Church, Crawl Space Ninja. I got a great Ask a Ninja from a gentleman out of Louisiana. He's got a lot of wood rot fungus in his crawl space, and he's got some interesting questions here. And I just wanted to share this information because a lot of people think that ventilation is the right way to handle humidity in a humid environment. And, you know, how do you address the mold and all that sort of stuff? So this is from Brennan in New Iberia, Louisiana. If you're familiar with that area, great. If not, I had to look it up. It's near the Lafayette, Louisiana area. Let's read what he says. So, I have a wood rot fungus issue in some areas under my house. It is not encapsulated and no insulation is in the subfloor. I'm trying to find out the most reasonable way to clean and treat under the house. I was thinking about pressure washing with added chemicals and cleaners and wanted to install some exhaust fans. I have a large passive vent all throughout the house. My concern is how much airflow do I need to ensure it stays dry? And is there such a thing as too much airflow as it would draw in more humid air causing condensation in the crawl space? The house is 2,700 square feet, about 2 feet tall. So we've got about 5,400 cubic feet of air that we're talking about. Environmental conditions in the area, according to Brennan, are 50 degrees Fahrenheit in the winter and about 50% humidity and 100% humidity and 100 degrees in August. Also, how should I arrange the fans for the best airflow? It's a rectangular house. So I'm going to throw up some pictures as I'm talking here, Brennan, but basically I did a little bit of research about where you're located and I looked up the average humidity in New Iberia, hopefully I'm saying that right, New Iberia, Louisiana, and the average humidity where you live is currently 61%. Now keep in mind, that's average, and a lot of people get this confused. So they'll look at, okay, so it's 50 degrees and 50% humidity today. Like I'm looking at the weather and that's what it is. But they don't take into consideration how much the humidity fluctuates during the day, okay? So like, for example, at my house, it's kind of foggy where I'm at. So in the morning, when I get up, you know, there could be a lot of fog outside, which burns off around noon. And then as the temperatures go down in the evening, that fog returns the next day. So if you average that 24-hour period, it may be an average of 55% humidity, but it was 100% humidity for 4 to 6 hours in the morning, and then it kind of burns off down to, you know, 40% humidity. You're asking me about how much ventilation I need, how much is too much and all that. I don't recommend any ventilation if you're looking to control humidity. Ventilation is used to control soil gases. I've done a lot of videos about this. The Indoor Air Plus program by the EPA talks about 1 CFM of air for every 50 square feet of crawl space. That's to address soil gases. Now, there's more soil gases than just radon out there, but anything coming out of the soil could give an odor to your house or affect the indoor air quality. So that's the Indoor Air Plus program by the EPA. Ventilation and soil gases, but 79% humidity, 100% humidity in August with 100% Fahrenheit temperature is a lot of moisture. There is no amount of ventilation you can do to control that humidity. So what you have to do, Brennan, is you have to seal all the vents of the crawl space and install a dehumidifier. In Louisiana, that is what I would recommend you do. Probably all parts of Louisiana. I don't know exactly what kind of foundation construction you have, whether you have brick or block or concrete. Some parts of Louisiana even have what's an open crawl space, so you can literally crawl in and out. It's kind of on pier and beam kind of crawl spaces. So not sure what you're dealing with there, but if you can make sure that you have a foundation wall and seal those vents, put in a dehumidifier, make sure you have a good vapor barrier down, that is what I would recommend to control humidity. Forget about the ventilation aspect of it. I mean, look at some of these pictures that we're talking about. There is no amount of ventilation that's going to dry up this wood for you to address the mold. So there is a lot of wood rot fungus in these pictures, and I'm just kind of going through them real quick. I'll throw some up as I'm talking. But basically, this is a serious problem. Your foundation is being eaten from underneath you, your subfloor, your joist, all that is being eaten. Imagine, try to think of this as termites. You have wood rot fungus, which is basically destroying the lignin of the wood and creating a structural problem in your house. And you need to get that crawl space dry as quickly and efficiently as possible. That's why you need a dehumidifier. So let's talk about your second question. Can you use a pressure washer with chemicals? Well, if you were to put Anabec, the 5-gallon pail of Anabec in the pressure washer, that might work. But I'm a little concerned because if you're going to pressure wash your subfloor, you've got tongue and groove flooring. And I can see all of that liquid, no matter what kind of liquid you use, is going to go into your house. So I don't like the idea of using a liquid pressure washer to address mold. I think soda blasting is obviously what we use, and that's the best way to handle it. If you can't get access to a soda blaster, then I think the best thing for you to do, once you get the wood dry, you get the humidity corrected, is to go down there with some wire brushes and a good mold cleaner like Anabec or the YCS cleaner, and just start, you know, scrubbing that mold off. You know, it's going to take a lot of elbow grease and a lot of liquid cleaner to get that mold scrubbed off. But if you're doing this yourself, that's probably going to be the best way for you to handle this mold situation. If you can find someone local to soda blast it for you after you get it all dried out, I would certainly go that route if possible. But I hope this helps you out, Brennan. I hope you got enough good information to take care of your crawl space based on this video. But if you need more help, probably the best thing for us to do is to do a consultation. I'll put a link to that down below if you want to do a consultation with me. And I'm Michael Church with Crawl Space Ninja. We hope you make it a happy and blessed day, and we'll see you later.